Howdy, 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 my beautiful Cancer. How are you doing? Today, we're going to get into your weekly tarot reading, Cancer, for August. All right, so if you enjoy this tarot reading today, let me know in the comments below and give this video a like and subscribe. It's completely free to do and helps me out a lot. Today, Cancer, we're going to get into three rows for you, darling. All right, your first row, we're going to be talking about the person that's on your mind right now. Cancer, could be platonic, could be romantic, could be something business related. I just know it's not my business to know what's happening, all right, or what this relationship is. Your second row today, Cancer, we're going to be talking about what you need to hear today. Could be a spiritual message. It could just serve as a confirmation of something happening in your life. And then in your third row today, Cancer, we're going to be talking about predictions for you. While the future is never solid, darling, I can still give you a good idea about what's going to happen in your life should you follow in this current energy. All right, starting this out though, Cancer, we have this Hierophant coming in here for you. All right, in the back of the deck, I love this energy for you, Cancer. All right, this is, I feel like it's not your energy. All right, it's not, you know, it's not your energy, Cancer, but it's what it is that I feel like every Cancer craves. Like, this is the juice, honey. This is the key. This is your skeleton key, right? Cancer, this is everything that a Cancer is craving out of life, socially, career-wise here. When you're saying, it's like, what the heck does that mean, Velca, right? What is the Hierophant? The Hierophant represents commitment. It represents devotion. It can be known as the card of marriage, all right? I ain't saying that you're getting married, Cancer, all right? I'm just letting you know. I ain't saying you're getting married. But you take that marriage aspect and you apply it to everything else. So it's like, you think about marriage and it's for the long term, all right, through thick and thin, honey, through sickness and health, all right? And so it's still gonna see you through until the end here. And so what I see happening for you, Cancer, in the coming days is the energy that you're going to be working with is going to be energy that is going to take you through the good times as well as the bad times. The people that you're going to be investing your energy into this week are going to be people that you know you can trust. And those that you can't trust, they're going to be showing themselves to you here. All right. Pay attention. This is a message that I want to be saying to you, Cancer, is like, if they wanted to, they would. All right, that's a key point there. It's like, if they wanted to, they would, Cancer. If that job wanted to keep you, they would find the money to pay more for you. If that friendship, if that friend, if that lover, if that crush wanted to talk to you, they could. You know, it's 2022, Cancer, darling, all right? When people say, it's just like, oh, I sent that text message, but I guess it didn't go through. It's just like, well, where did it go? It doesn't, text messages just don't disappear, all right? When people say, it's just like, oh, I didn't have my phone on me, darling, like, think about it. When's, like, when you're hanging out with them, when you're talking to them, how often do they have their phone on them? If it's all the time, darling, which 90% of the time it usually is, most people, you know, it's the same people, Cancer, that say they don't have their phone on them or they never have their phone around them, but every time you're around them, they're on their phone, you know? And so, Cancer, for you, you're going to be seeing what is worth it to you. You're going to be seeing this week about even what it is that you've been investing into, maybe when it comes to projects this week here, Cancer. You're going to be shown what is going to be worth the squeeze, right? So let's see here. And that's a quote from Minnow Pond. That's what kept on sitting in my head. He always would say, is the juice worth the squeeze, right? Essentially saying, it's just like, you know how we have like those lives, honey, especially if you go to like a taco truck, sometimes it's usually not the taco trucks. It's usually just like those Mexican restaurants that don't have a single Hispanic person cooking in the back. And they give you those limes and you squeeze them and they don't have no juice, honey. Right. That's what I think about. And every time Middle Pond says, is the juice worth the squeeze? And that's what I get for you here, Cancer. All right. So let's talk about this person on your mind, darling. All right. Whether you like it or not, you have the Seven of Cups here, Two of Wands, and that Hermit energy here. I feel like when it comes to this person here, Cancer, you have to just take them at face value. All right. The quote as well that I want to tell for you guys is the quote from Maya Angelou is like, when people show you who they are the first time, believe them. And this could apply for this entire time that I've been running my mouth here. But I feel like for you, Cancer, it's just like, how they're reacting to you now is how they're going to be treating you in the future, is how they truly see you here. And so I feel like for you, Cancer, you're in this place now where you're just like, you're asking yourself, being like, all right, starting to consider other options. I see for some of you guys here trying to figure out what your next plan is when it comes to them. Do you continue this journey with them, or do you continue this journey finding somebody else, right? You have to remember, Cancers, like, don't be afraid of pulling the Hermit energy on people, all right? You guys need to value your energy more, because even if this person doesn't make you feel as if your energy is valuable, it really is here, Cancer. And you'll see that for sure, that they actually understand how valuable your energy is, because I see the moment you start pulling back and start looking at other options, that's when it's like that once they realize that they could potentially lose you, Cancer, that's when you see their true potential, right? Magically, they go from not being able to text at all to constantly texting you when you are out living your life, doing other things here, Cancer. All right. It's almost as if this person is just like keeping tabs on you and just making sure that like you're not, it's like that, it sounds morbid, but it's like that sense that they want, Cancer, where it's just like they don't want to see you happy with anything else or anybody else, but at the same time, they don't want to be the one to make you happy either. Right. And so it's interesting, but I want to point out with this here, Cancer, all right, with this Two of Wands, you see this person, the Two of Wands is usually depicted by someone that's holding a globe or has like the world around them, like they're in control. All right, Cancer. So this is kind of a message where it's just like, there's plenty of fish in the sea. There's plenty of other people, Cancer, that would see your value, appreciate your value, and raise your value even more. Oh, not my citrine vial falling. We'll just put it here. But yeah, that's what I get for you here, Cancer. It's just like you're asking the question, being like, all right, is the juice worth the squeeze with this here? So let's clarify these cards. We have the King of Swords here, as well as the Ten of Wands. And then we got the Page of Cups here in the back of the deck. Let me show you guys these three at once here. Hold on, Cancer. All right. So I'm going to be honest here, Cancer. I feel like your journey is taking you to this, for many of you, taking you to this place of being like, all right, this, you know, Ten of Wands here. You know, like this, you realize like this relationship, this situation with this person, it's just, it's too much, right? It's in this place for you, Cancer. I feel like it's run its course. King of Swords here. I feel like once you're honest with yourself, when, you know, the King of Swords is someone that's very confident in themselves, very confident in how they see the world and what have you. And I see for you, Cancer, as you build up your confidence and what it is that you bring to the table, that Page of Cups energy comes in response. All right. Page of Cups talks about new people coming into your life. It also represents new opportunities coming in as well. So it could just be doors in general. All right. I know this is about social things for you, but I do feel inclined to bring up the opportunity aspect as well, which leads me to believe, Cancer, if you were to be in this hermit phase, really reflecting on it and be like, you know, I've had this person in my life for a long time now. Do they really provide any happiness to me anymore? Right? It's through the deep questions that you're reflecting on yourself here. And then I don't know, I just see progression on your path, but progression without that person here. I feel like you are moving on, moving to bigger and better things, Cancer, but it does require you to have more confidence in celebrating yourself, giving yourself more credit. All right. Because I don't feel like they do. Working through your feelings as well. For some of you, Cancers, you need to work through your feelings. Yeah, I mean, that's literally what it is. Working through your feelings of just like feeling like you're not enough when you clearly are, Cancer. All right. So enough on that. I'm not going to run my mouth too much on that. But let's talk about what you need to hear today, Cancer. Okay. Now this, honey. Cancer, darling. This is a doozy of a row. Anyone that knows tarot, honey, y'all are probably clicking off of this video now. He's like, I don't want any of this energy here, Velca. What you need to hear at this time, Cancer, I'm going to be very blunt with you, honey. You got that Five of Wands, Seven of Swords, as well as the Devil card here. You got yourself a doozy here, darling. What you need to hear at this time is you need to accept the fact, Cancer, that there is certain things in your life that are just no longer serving you. And not only just now, they're no longer serving you, but you're around leeches. You're around people who are just taking your energy and sabotaging you, all right? It's this sense, Cancer, I don't know why, but I see like with the Seven of Swords here, it's just like I see like a Cancer just like in this like an encampment, at a camp, darling, like in the middle of the woods with a few other people, and it's like you gather all these nuts and berries and what have you, and you have like a stockpile, like you don't keep it to yourself, you have a stockpile, Cancer, and then because like to you, you're just like, no, y'all are my friends, I'm gonna take care of you, whatever, like we're all in this together, everyone's gonna put in their equal parts, right? Reality is I see someone that is just like sneaking in and just taking the berries and the nuts, but also never like helping at all. They're not getting more resources. They're not doing anything. They're just causing more burdens, causing more stress in your life here. And so for many of you, Cancers, I feel like it's a tough pill for you to swallow of accepting someone in your life. I just heard family member and then mom. So I know for a fact that's not all of you guys here. But some of you guys, a tough pill to swallow is like realizing that there's someone in your life that just doesn't care for you in the way that you care for them. And I feel like for many of you guys, you're going to wake up and realize just like, you know what? This ain't worth it here. But again, I feel like for many of you Cancers, I just see confidence coming in for you. All right. Allow me to be the first person to tell you, Cancer, that it is completely okay to gas yourself up. Gas yourself up at this time, Cancer. Look in the mirror and find every reason possible of why you are beautiful, why you're smart here. You guys need to be gassed up, all right? You guys need to, because you are not seeing yourself in the way that I see you, Cancer, all right? Clarifying this, we have the Ace of Wands, Seven of Pentacles coming out here, and the King of Wands coming in here. Back of the deck here, Eight of Swords, all right? So ultimately, Eight of Swords is that card where it's just like, delusions, like self-delusions there, right? Because it's like what it is that you think is not the reality, right? You're trapped, but it's like it's trapped, being trapped due to your own thought process, due to your own mindset. Now, King and Ace of Wands here with the Seven of Pentacles for you, it's interesting here. It's like Cancer, the world like responds really beautifully to you having more confidence. Take note, this is the second King coming in for you here. More authority is coming into your life here. You are destined, you're worthy of so much more, Cancer. All right. And I see for my Cancers here, like as you build up this confidence, not only does it reflect beautifully for your social relationships, like I see that very clearly with this there, but also opportunities. It's like for some of you guys, I want to just sit here and ask you, Cancers, like, why aren't you applying for that managerial role? Why are you not applying for something greater? Why are you not, you know, it's this sense of being like, why are you working the front desk when I know for a fact you could be running the business, Cancer? Why are you dealing with these people over here when I know for a fact if you were to just make the decision and be like, hey, you know what? Y'all ain't my crowd. You would be around a crowd that's celebrating you so much more. You have Will-O-Wisp here, number 8 in numerology, so be sure to look that up at a later point in time, Cancer. Treasures hidden in the shadows here for you, all right? Treasures hidden in the shadows. The shadows really representing the unknown for you, Cancer, all right? This is the time that y'all need to be taking more risks, Cancer. The more that you risk it, when you risk it for the biscuit, you get the biscuit and then the honey and then some honey. You get the two-piece and the biscuit from Popeyes, darling, all right? Take more risks at this time. The world opens up as you do as well. For many of you guys, you're being a little bit too shy. Your confidence is like, I'm noticing, it's just like the confidence is the key point here, all right? What can you do, Cancer, this week that builds up your confidence here? Because as you build up your confidence, that's how you invest in your life. That's how you make those breakthroughs in your life, is that confidence, is by knowing that you deserve more, all right? Demanding more, not being afraid of coming off as the bad guy, right? So that's what I see on that for you, Cancer. Don't mind me, I'm taking a time-stamped note here. Actually, I want to get some more oracle cards before we get into your predictions here. But I will start talking about this as I start shuffling for your prediction, for your oracle cards here. Your predictions, we have that Death and Chariot energy with that Five of Swords coming in here for you, Cancer. And this is really your energy here. So I know you're going to be getting empowered. Let it go, darling. Let it go. I mean, matter of fact, darling, what have we just been talking about this entire time, Cancer? All right, honey. It's almost as if I decided Cancer to be like, let me pull some oracle cards here, you know, but it's literally just like the epitome is like, I pulled these cards just so I can tell you, be like, see, I told you so, right? Being like, see, I was right here, Cancer, right? It's time for you to be letting go of certain people. I want to be pointing out as well, Cancer, the hummingbirds, because I feel like, and that could just be completely wrong, but I feel like for some of you guys, there's some type of spiritual significance when it comes to hummingbirds at this current point in time. I know hummingbirds have their own, I mean, most animals have some type of metaphysical representation to them, Cancer, but I feel like hummingbirds have play a relevant role in your life right now. And it may be just like a sign in the coming days when you see hummingbirds, but I feel like hummingbirds are really an important key part, all right? So getting into your predictions now, let me show you these cards properly here. But it's, I mean, naturally, when you have that let it go energy, then you have that Death card coming in here, Five of Swords, you know, the continuing on with those fives, with that Five of Wands or what have you, and then the Chariot. Chariot is your energy here, Cancer, ultimately. Girl, I say the Chariot and then I show the Death. I mean, ultimately here, Cancer, the Chariot is your energy, right? I do see you guys feeling more empowered. I do see you, Cancer, in the coming days getting more comfortable with yourself here. And I see you, Cancer, finally cutting away at the leeches. I feel like this is the problem here, Cancer. It's like you have so many leeches around you. And it's just like you're realizing who's truly like a ride or die. You're realizing there's certain people that are just like, oh, yeah, I'm here to support you, Cancer. I love you, Cancer, da, 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 da. But then you realize they only love you as far until it gets tough, right? And then you realize that they're the ones that, like, when it comes down to the showdown, they're the ones that are walking away, right? They're the ones that are calling it quits when things get tough, when you're not able to always provide to them and they have to put in some work, right? That's when you realize being like, oh, y'all don't mess with me like that, right? And the key part about this here, Cancer, is like they're going to be regretting it so much more later down the road, Cancer, about like them like taking you for granted and not putting in the effort. Because it's like the reason why you have all these people saying just like, oh, I'm going to be your ride or die commitment and all that, right? Because I feel like for many of you, Cancer, it's like commitment in all aspects of your life has just been very fleeting for you here. Your story is going to be getting so much better because not only because of just, I mean, obviously my optimism. And with this chariot card coming in here, representing just quick forward momentum for you, I always say the chariot's like the Uber service from spirit. But, Cancer, things are going to be getting better for you because the opportunities come forward to the kings, all right? The kings are the ones that open the door. The kings are the ones that bring forth the wealth, all right? It's through that confidence for you. And so, I don't know, I get like this sense of where it's just like, after you let go of these people that say they were your ride or die and you realize that they weren't, it's like spirit is waiting for you to address those people, address these things that are just really, in essence, just devil that play as the devil in your life, Cancer. They're waiting for you to dispel those things because that's when your success story starts, is afterwards, because they don't want you to be surrounded in abundance, Cancer. And while you have all these leeches attached to you, because all those leeches are going to just leech off of your abundance here. You're too fragmented, so do whatever it takes you need to do, Cancer, to get grounded at this time here. And I feel like for many of you guys here, this is just like the key component of where it's just like, pick up these final pieces, do whatever you need to do to fully see yourself in the truest of ways, Cancer, all right? Seeing yourself in the truest of ways where it's not under the filters of like past traumas that have told, like, that have made you feel like you're not as valuable and what have you, all right? The more that you heal yourself, the more that you're going to have further abundance in your life here. Now, I know abundance, I mean, I keep on saying abundance as well, but I know it's such an overused term here, but I truly do feel like spirit doesn't want to give you these blessings until you take care of the leeches, all right? And part of that as well, let's take away the spirit aspect. Again, the more confident that you are, Cancer, and you go forward with things that you feel like doing and what have you, again, just like the sense of confidence, removing the insecurities that you have and just posting it anyways, right? You know, don't be afraid of showcasing your personality. Who cares if someone thinks that you're fat or that you're too skinny or that you're ugly or just whatever, Cancer? Because it's like, that's their perception. That's not you. Right? That's not how, you know, just other people's perceptions of you is not your, does not identify you. All right. I'm going to say that again, just because someone perceives you in a specific type of way, Cancer, doesn't mean that's who you truly are. All right. So many people on YouTube, on TikTok, everywhere, Cancer, are so convinced that they know me as a person because of the content I post when it's not even like 1%, like it's my, the content I post is such an iota of my personality, but people are so convinced that they know me, you know. But and so people will say stuff and it's just like, I'm so confident in myself because I know who I am, that these people are irrelevant, all right, that try to bring you down here, all right. Be more of like a I am Cancer, hear me roar. Don't be afraid of taking up more space, Cancer. All right, darling? So that's the tarot reading that I have for you, darling. Remember to let me know how this reading helps you out. To give this video a like and subscribe because it's completely free to do and it helps me out, Cancer. Be sure to check out your Sun, Moon, Rising as well as your Venus sign, and I'll connect with you later on, Cancer. Bye, darling.